Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is Synthetic Division Part 1. In this video, I show you how to use synthetic division instead of long division to divide polynomials by linear polynomials, such as this problem we do. 3x squared minus 5x plus 1 divided by x plus 4. We also do this using long division and we check our answer, but I don't explain why synthetic division works. That would be on another video. We could always use long division to do this problem, 3x squared minus 5x plus 1 divided by x plus 4. So let's just go ahead and do that as a reminder. So one thing you can do is, remember, you're really dividing by this whole thing, x plus 4, right? And so you have to think, x times what will give you this 3x squared? If you don't know how to do long division, look at my videos on long division. And then we really have to multiply 3x times this entire quantity, x plus 4. So that's really the distributive property. 3x times x is plus 3x squared. And 3x times 4 is plus 12x. But when you do division, the next step would be to subtract. So what I'm going to do is show that I'm really just going to change signs and add. So in other words, instead of adding 3x squared, remember I'm subtracting 3x squared. Instead of adding 12x, I'm subtracting it. So I have 3x squared minus 3x squared, which of course shouldn't be anything. And then negative 5x minus 12x, be careful that you change the sign there and add, is a negative 17x. So this gives me negative 17x, and then you bring down the next term. All right, and then we do it again. X times what will give me negative 17x? Well, that's going to be, let's use a different color, minus 17. So we have negative 17 times x gives you the negative 17x. Remember, when you first do it, it should be exactly the same thing, right? And then negative 17 times 4 will give you a negative 68. And remember, we want to subtract all this, so I'm just going to change signs. So I'm going to put the opposite sign and pay attention to that sign instead. So negative 17x plus 17x is 0, so we don't write anything down. And then 1 plus 68 is 69. And that's our remainder. So how do we write this answer? Up here is the quotient, the 3x minus 17. So the answer is 3x minus 17. The remainder is 69. Remember, we write 69 over what we divided by, and what we divided by was this x plus 4. And so this would be the answer. Okay, that works out great. Now I'm going to show you something called synthetic division. I'm not going to explain why it's true, because that might take a whole video. I might do that on some other video. But for now, I'm going to show you how to do synthetic division and show you how we can get the same answer much quicker. So we're going to start with the same problem. 3x squared minus 5x plus 1 divided by x plus 4. And over here I'm reminding you what we got for the answer when we did long division. All right, here are the steps. We take what we're dividing by, and you're going to set it equal to 0 and solve for x. X equals negative 4. All right, that's the first step. And then we put that negative 4 in a little kind of upside down box like this. All right? The next thing we do is we take the coefficients of this polynomial, okay, and we've got to make sure we write this polynomial in descending order. So we have the 3x, we have the x squared term, the x term, and then the constant. If you have something to the second power, there should be three coefficients. If you add it to the third power, there would be four coefficients. So you might have some that have, like this could have been 3x squared plus 1, and you would have to write that as plus 0x, for instance. We'll do some like that. So we take these coefficients in order. So we've got the 3, the negative 5, and the 1. All right, so the we start over this x plus 4, solve for x, put it in this little box over here. And then we take the coefficients of the polynomial and write those in order, 3, negative 5, 1. And we leave a space underneath it, and then we draw a line. And you know how we have this kind of half box over here? We're going to put another half box down here. Okay, so this is the setup. And here's all you do. You start off with the first term here, the 3, and you just bring it down. You're adding down. There's just a 3. Okay? We take that and multiply it by what's in the box and put it up here. So what we're going to do is multiply and then put the answer up here. So we have negative 4 times 3 gives me negative 12. And then we add down again. So we've got negative 5 plus negative 12, and that's negative 17. And then we're going to do the same thing. We are going to, let me erase this. That's how we did it. We're going to do the same thing where we are going to multiply what's in the box by that new number, negative 4 times negative 17, and put it up here. And that will give me positive 68. And the last thing we do is add, and that goes in this final box right here. I'm going to write that the final box is 68. Now, what you're seeing here in the box, whoops, 1 plus 68 is 69. Okay. What's in the little box will be the remainder. Look at our answer we got before, the 69. These numbers down here will be the coefficients in order. What happened is you can only use synthetic division if you're dividing by a linear factor. So it has to be x plus a number or x minus a number. And I'll show you how to do if it has a coefficient like 3x plus a number. But you can't have an x squared term to use this. So if the original problem was 3x squared and you're dividing by an x, these linear factors go down. So these are the coefficients of the answer. 3x minus 17. So the answer will be 3x minus 17 plus, all right, the 69, and look up what you were dividing by is right here, x plus 4. We get the same answer. If you want, instead of realizing it starts with x, what you could say is, well, that's the remainder, that's the constant term, that would be the x term. If there was another one, that would be the x term, x squared term, etc. Okay, now, let's make sure that we actually got the right answer by checking. Now, we should do this whether we use long division or synthetic division. So, that's the last step I'm going to do. How would I check to make sure this was the correct answer? What you have to do is take what you were dividing by, x plus 4, multiply by the quotient, and add the remainder. So, that's exactly what we're going to do. We divided by x plus 4. So, here's how we're going to check. You're going to take what you divided by times the quotient and add the remainder. Now keep in mind the remainder is 69, but the way we write the answer is 69 over x plus 4. You just add 69. So we could do the FOIL method here. 3x squared minus 17x plus 12x minus 68 plus 69, and if we add like terms, we get 3x squared minus 5x plus 1. And the question is that what we started with? Yes, we did 3x squared minus 5x plus 1. So therefore, we did it correct. You would have to get this answer when you multiplied the quotient. So you have to do x plus 4 times, think of it this way, x plus 4 times 3x minus 17 plus this remainder down here has to equal what you started off with, this 3x squared minus 5x plus 1. So we've checked it, and that means this indeed is the correct answer. Okay. On the next video, instead of doing the long division 2, we will just go ahead and do some synthetic division. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.